Girl, 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 girl. Hello guys, welcome back to my channel on Kanelwa Gingrikani. Yes, I'm doing some ironing. You know, I know they say work from home, but sometimes it's good to do your ironing in case, you know, you have to go somewhere. So I'm busy here, look, ironing, iron at the brook. So guys, I just thought of something. With the whole COVID restrictions going on with regard to funerals, you know, you've seen the title. The title says, would you work at the mortuary, you know? It's a tough one, eh? Maybe before I tell you whether I can work at the mortuary or not, maybe it would be nice to talk about this issue with regard to viewing bodies, you know. Maybe we should look at the benefits of viewing your loved ones before you lay them to rest, you know. I've attended so many funerals during the COVID-19, and I've seen some people bury at 4 a.m., 2 a.m., 3 a.m., and you know, some people are not viewed, you know, there was no public viewing and all those things. So I'm asking myself, what are the psychological impact of not viewing your friend, your relative, or your colleague, or your loved one before you lay them to rest, you know, before they are put 6 feet under, you know, before they are buried, before they are buried. I mean, I know some traditions follow different, you know, ways of doing things. Some people like going to the mortuary and spend time with their loved ones for the rest of the week, you know, some before the burial. Some people like dressing up or bathing their loved ones before the burial. And with the COVID restrictions right now, it's a little bit complicated to practice your culture, your tradition, or your religion with regard to burials. So I was just thinking, like, what is the psychological impact of not having to practice those things? Because I know if you are familiar with someone and they passed on and you don't attend the funeral, it's I know my ironing is very bad, guys. But see me when I've put everything on, you know, I match everything nice, you know. But what is the impact of not being able to be allowed to view or even to attend the funeral because of COVID restrictions? Let's say someone, okay, let me say, let's put COVID away, because I know there's been a lot of stories with COVID. Some people got arrested for having more than the allowed or required number of people at the funeral. We've seen funerals of comrades, ANC comrades, where there was more than 50 people. You know, we never heard of any arrests, but ordinary people or someone like me can get arrested for allowing people to come to the funeral and be more than 50. You know, I mean, that's another politics altogether. You know, it depends with which these laws or these rules are for who? For the ordinary people, or are they for everybody? You know, those are the questions. But what is the impact of not being able to attend the funeral or not being able to view the body? Because I know that, maybe let me tell a story. When my mom passed on in 2008, it was on the 19th of February when she passed on. And during the week before the burial, we will visit as a family her at the mortuary, you know, and I would be able to see her. Even though I didn't bath her, I couldn't bath her. If I had a choice, I could. But at that time, my aunts were taking care of those things, you know, and all other things. But the fact that I went to see my mom at the mortuary, lying there, and being able to touch her, you know, and fix her, and fix her eyes, you know, being able to. I know it's a bit of a gory topic, this one, but I felt at peace, you know. Even at the burial or during the week, I was actually the strongest. It helped me to cope with all the stress of losing a loved one. Guys, I have so much. I have a lot of things that I have to go through here, so you can see it's a lot of things. I felt like doing that, going there and see my mom, you know, touch my mom, fix my mom, see her lying there at the mortuary, helped me deal with her death better, because I could always have those memories and I could get a satisfaction that she's resting in peace, you know, because I've seen her, I've watched her during the week, you know, and at the burial it was more easier for me, even though it was a bit of a touchy subject for me. I couldn't even stand it when the coffin was going down. I know most of you can relate, but during the week I was able to help out, to be strong, you know. It helped me a lot, that thing. So I can imagine the fact that now there's COVID, and even though someone didn't die because of COVID, there's so many restrictions, you know. People are not allowed to do their normal things. Yes, for safety reasons, of course, we understand. But what is the long-term psychology? Shlungu. What's the long term? Guys, Shlungu is Ngisa. Guys, what is the long-term psychological impact or effect, if there is a such, if it's there, of not viewing your loved ones, of not being able to watch them, not being able to dress them, you know, or not being able to touch them, or not even being able to be allowed to visit them because of the restrictions, you know. What kind of generations are we going to have because of this? Because I can only imagine. I mean, it took me, even though I went to see my mom when she was still lying in at the mortuary, it did take long for me to not really get over, because you can't really get over someone that you really love, someone that you lost. But it helped me in a way to deal with it. But I can imagine if you didn't get a chance to see your loved ones at the mortuary, or even to visit the place where they died or they passed on, if it was a car accident, because I know some people have rituals where they have to go and see the site where the person died, or do some rituals there, and also at the mortuary, and also when they dress them at the, like how they position them inside the coffin, you know, the type of clothes they put them on, you know, those things. I feel like they go a long way to help us as humans deal with losing someone very close to us, and the fact that we are now being denied those things. I know that they say previously, when COVID was still starting, they were saying that the health department was saying that no, you can't view the body. They had to put bodies in body bags and cover them with so many plastics, you know, so that in fear of, because people didn't know, the health department only confirmed now there's this minimal transmission of the virus from a dead body. So now people can be able to view their loved ones, but they can't touch them. They still can't touch them. That's what the Department of Health is saying in South Africa. But I can imagine if you did not get a chance to view your loved ones, or to see them lying there in a mortuary, or being able to watch them, or treat them, or just talk to them. Because I know sometimes some people do things differently. They want to go and talk to your dad, your father, your mom, your uncle, your sister, you know, whoever you passed on. You want to spend time with them before the burial. Because I feel like that moment is very, very important in us dealing with the grief and death. Because some people develop a mental illness from losing a loved one. So I've seen it at home. My late brother, I felt like the psychologist confirmed at the hospital that he actually was dealing with grief. That he actually went the way he started behaving, you know, because of grief. Because he did not deal with losing our mom in a right way, in a manner that was suitable for him. Because sometimes our cultures dictate as to how we should mourn, and people mourn differently, you know. And those things, I feel like they will have a long-term mental illness in our society for the fact that we're not able to attend your uncle's funeral or your mom's funeral, or you're not even allowed to touch them or speak to them or visit them at the mortuary. I'm just scared. I'm just worried. I don't know you guys if you can relate to what I'm talking about, that what is the long-term impact of not viewing or not being able to perform your normal rituals for your loved ones, you know? What is the long-term results of these things? Because I feel like I'm actually scared that we're going to have a society that has not dealt with grief, or has not dealt with losing a loved ones in a long term, and is going to cause a lot of people who suffer from bipolar or disorders and all these things. I mean, we know if someone goes missing, someone that is your family member goes missing, some people develop illness because of the fact that they can't put closure to the fact that their loved ones is gone, you know. Maybe it's a subject we can talk about sometimes in a long term, but this is, I've just felt like there must be a psychological impact for not having to deal with grief or the fact that you lost someone else that is very, very close to you. And I know, like I said, when people go missing, people develop some sicknesses, bipolar disorders, mental illness, for the fact that they didn't get to see their loved ones, their last remains. They haven't found them. They don't know where they are. They wish they could just at least know where they are, or find out what happened to them, or recover their remains, you know, at least bury something, you know. So I can't imagine for the fact that people are not allowed or to be at the funeral anymore. I mean, we know in a village when someone passed on, the at home, I remember when we buried my brother, it was packed, you know. And I can imagine, because he was a person of people. So imagine if those people didn't get a chance to come and see him for the last time and say their goodbyes. You know, when you meet someone for the first time, you hug them, give them a hug, and then when they leave, you say, "Oh, sure. Hey, that's a signal. It says at least you've seen me go away." But if you have not seen that person go away, you just hear from people talking that, "Oh, so and so passed on and he was buried yesterday." You're like, "Oh, he passed on and was buried. You didn't get a chance to say your goodbyes or go and speak to them if you were very close family or friend." You know, those things I fear will have a long-term impact in our society, and I just felt like maybe we should talk about it. Maybe those radio producers who are there, who are watching my show, can actually take this subject further to their radio stations and talk about it. You know, I know people who work in the media watch my shows, and then they freestyle on my topics, most of them. So they can take this kind of subject and then discuss it further on air and hear what people say. Yeah, so that's what I had, guys, as I'm doing my ironing. I'm sorry I had to start off on a very touchy subject on this channel. Gingrican Media is our channel. Yes, so we're gonna be doing a lot of talkings here, yeah, normal talk. So if you guys have been following me for so long, you know that I've been doing music analysis. Yes, we'll still talk about music, but I just also wanted to talk about things that affect us or have an impact in our lives in different ways. Things like this, like this kind of things. We could have a comment. You can leave your comment. You can discuss these kind of things, and then help us, maybe not that it's going to change anything, but just to help us exchange ideas and share our stories. Because I know that when my brother passed on, I was able to go and visit him at the mortuary again, you know, and that helped me as well to know that, okay, he's passed on, he's late, it's him, you know. Also, there was a viewing at home. People who were very close to the family wanted to see him, went and see him. But I can't imagine if you did not get that chance. Because, I mean, if I'm very close to someone, I just can't imagine not having an opportunity to see them at least at the burial, you know, at least have an open coffin or something. Okay, I think now it's allowed to have an open coffin. Before, when COVID was starting, it was not allowed, but now it's allowed. So, at least, you know, but at least. Yeah, 50 people, guys. I'm sorry. It's crazy. These laws and regulations. I'm sorry. I know people can contract viruses when there's so many people at the funeral. We've seen the stats, you know. That's what it says. Many people in South Africa, actually, yeah, let me talk about South Africa because that's where I've read the stats from, that many people contracted the virus from funerals, you know. And so, yes, we have to take precautions, but we have to be mindful of the fact that we as humans are spiritual, you know. We behave and we survive because of our spirituality. You know, we become successful because of the maybe not interference, but contribution of how spirituality or how spiritual we are. You know, we survive in different ways and we progress in different ways because of our spiritualities, you know, and burying someone, for me, it's also a spiritual phenomena that should be allowed in some instance, you know. But recently, because of coronavirus, it's never been allowed. People bury their loved ones without viewing them, touching them, speaking to them, dressing them up or bathing them. All those necessary what do you call it, traditions or customs, depending on your culture, you know. So yeah, it's a very thorny topic right now. Yeah, and I just felt like maybe we should discuss it. Like I said, producers, please go out there and maybe let's talk about these kind of topics, things that will help us grow and get in touch with ourselves and also with our loved ones that are late. So my name is Legere. We'll be doing a lot of stuff on this channel, so invite other people, share the video if you like it, and also leave your comment down below. Tell us your story and also share your experience of how you had to bury your loved ones without viewing them, and how has that impacted your life? Because there has to be an impact. There has to be something that's going to happen. You know, we cannot pretend as if we are a computer or we are just plastic. We are not. You know, we are a spiritual being. And we deserve those kind of send-offs, even though our loved ones also deserve the necessary send-off based on our cultures and traditions. So let's now answer the question: would I work at the mortuary? Would you work at the mortuary? I would visit, like I've said, that I visited my loved ones, my family members at the mortuary. I've done that twice. For both of them, actually, that's what I mean. But I don't think I'll work at the mortuary. I feel like it takes a lot of guts. You need to really have a particular kind of inner strength for you to be able to work at the mortuary. Strength that will carry you in those conditions, you know. So, unfortunately, I don't think I can work at the mortuary. Would you? Oh, someone is texting me there. I wonder who's that. Maybe they've seen me. They are watching the video. I don't know where. Guys, thank you very much for joining me on Kanel wa Gingrikan. My name is Mandela Gere. Yeah. So also go out there and iron your clothes, guys. Thank you very much, guys.